have waited for him.
We have waited for him.
We will be glad.
We will be glad
and rejoice in his salvation.
In his salvation. Hallelujah. God won't save us too. In that day. You know, if you ever received salvation. Hallelujah. If you have received it, and if you want to receive it, and you have received it, you want to have it in that day. Hallelujah. Then when Jesus comes back, it's over. A lot of folks won't try to get in a hurry then. They're going to run for that life. The Bible says some going to run to the mountain. They're going to run to the rocks. Tell the rocks to fall on them. Run that day. Uh-huh. Right now you got a whole lot of time. You don't have to run fast.
Yes, sir.
But in that day you're going to try to run fast. Too late. Yeah. Too late. But you need to do it right now.
Uh-huh.
You've been waiting on it. And some have nerve enough to wait on it. And then they haven't gotten their house and all.
Uh-huh.
You got to get your house and all. There's no way for God to save you in sin. No way for God to save you. Somebody said, well, the Lord saved me and I was drunk. No, he didn't. No, you weren't drunk when God saved you. You had to be saved. They said, well, I was shagging up. No, you weren't shagging up either. You didn't get this type of salvation that we have. Somebody there said, well, you know, I'm committing adultery, and I kept right on. No, you just think you were saved. And the homosexual said, well, we've been homosexual all of our life. You still one. God haven't saved you yet. You are not saved. God don't save you on top of sin. If you were a rogue, you still a rogue. Yeah, well, you just come to church. Huh? And that is your right. You can come to church all you want. But in order for you to go into God's kingdom, you got to get rid of all of those sins. And all of those sins that you have committed. That's what we just named some sins. Is that right? Sin. If those things are in your life,
right.
If you haven't gotten rid of them, if you haven't sanctified yourself,
right. Then
you are still what you were. And you are not going. Somebody says, well, who are you to say where we going? Now, God is not going to come in. If God came here and died for us, he died and suffered for you on the cross. So you can be saved. Don't you know you can't continue to go the way you're going? I listened to one Caucasian brother preaching a message. The Caucasian brother was saying, well, as you know, this grace group, he called them grace group. There is a group evidently have changed the real meaning of grace. They call them this grace group. This grace group think you can do any and everything and still be saved. Sometimes you don't know who they are, but they say, well, you know, God, he'll save you. Although you don't do anything, don't ever believe that. When God told you to sanctify yourself, that meant that you're going to leave everything alone. Then if you sanctify yourself, then the God that we are serving will sanctify you completely. He will sanctify you completely. You get to do the first one. Amen? So you can't listen to everything. You can hear it, but don't let it come in your ear to sell it. Make you think this is the way. I oftentimes say that there's a lot of voices out in the world, and I tell you, sometimes it's two voices. I break them down to two voices. can feel it.
Amen.
I feel it in my bones.
All right.
Yeah. I feel it in my bones, and God keep refreshing it in my mind that holiness has changed. What we have done, we've taken the Old Testament, and what we're supposed to do is add to it.
Right.
Is that right? Add to it. Yeah. This is a day of grace. The Lord said his grace is sufficient. That's unmerited favor. This is something that you don't deserve. Yeah, the Lord has given us what? Grace. Now I want you to know that this whole world, hallelujah, is at the mercy of God and their own grace. It's a grace period. And be in and out of sin and think that you're going to make it into God's kingdom. He that sinned, let him sin
no more.
No more.
Amen.
Let him sin no more. Word, that's the word. That's God's word. If you sin, no more. Hallelujah. All right, I can go on. The psalmist let us know, he said, I waited for the Lord. He said, my soul do it, wait.
Yeah.
And in his word do I hope? I hope in God's word. God's word, hallelujah, is what I'm standing on. His word is my bond. If you can tell me something that pertains to the way you live this day and you say this, well, they say this wrong. If you can show me in the word, then I got something else to show you too. Because I don't. It would be a battle right now. I know that God's word is right what he said. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I'm hoping. Yeah. My hope is in God's word. His word. Bring you up to his word so you can learn to depend on what he said and his word. Hallelujah. One writer said, my people are destroyed. Why? For the lack of knowledge. Yeah. We don't get in the word enough. Then sometimes when you don't have it all, learn how to use your context in your Bible.
Yeah.
Look up some things and see what God is saying. You know, write down some things when the minister preaching. Write it down. And then you say, well, I'm going to see this for myself. You can do a study yourself, not me. Yeah, because the world is full of knowledge. God has given knowledge. Amen.
Yeah.
He has given knowledge. So you can't. situation that's happening in your house, in your home, wait on him. I'm about to say, ain't nobody but me, and still could be something going on. That one question. It could be some turmoil in your house. And it takes God to straighten it out. So I've been bringing to Bishop Curtis, and Bishop Curtis has been praying, and the prayer band been praying, Elder Manasseh and others been praying. They're still wait on God. Evidently, God wants you to go through something. God wants you to come up. So therefore, you got to wait on. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. You ought to tell yourself, I know God won't fix it. Is that right? Amen. Encourage yourself. Amen. I know God won't fix it. Amen. How do you know? How do you know, Richard? I know because God has fixed it for me in the past. If you know that God has done something for you in the past, I don't care if it ain't, it's not one thing. Know that God will fix it.
Amen.
He's going to work it out. Amen. So quit panicking.
All right.
You just can't be still. Years ago, somebody was going through some things. Then they put out the way, well, I'm going to just go and get a drink. I said, what in the world are you going to drink for? And you have a problem.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Or you going to go out and get a hit, marijuana, and you in trouble. You need God to help you. Why would you go and sin? Then look for God to help you. Wait on God, have patience. Wait on, and know that God will fix it. Be of good courage. And the Bible tells you, he share strength thine heart. God will make you strong. You can, and then you be walking around with confidence. I know.
Yes, sir.
You be talking to yourself. How many of y'all talk to yourself? It's all right to talk to yourself as long as you don't answer yourself. Well, you can talk to yourself. You start talking and answering. Yeah, Richard. I'm on this. It's all right. Strengthen your heart. Then the psalmist said, wait.
That's it.
He said, wait. In other words, this is what I said. He said, I said,
wait
on the Lord. He knows something. He knows God. He knows something. That's why he put emphasis on wait on God. Yeah. The psalmist said, my soul wait thy own. But my expectation is from him. I don't expect man to do nothing pertaining to spiritual things. I expect God to do it. I expect God to do everything spiritual for me. Man can't do spiritual things. Only God can do it. He may tell you what I can do, but not help if, especially pertaining to man. He hardly help. You out there just like me, you on your own. But I dare you to take it to the Lord. And I thank God to live so we can go to God. And God, he will come in and he will fix it. And it won't take him long to fix it for you. Yeah. Sometimes it seems like God gonna wait too long. It does. Yeah. It may seem like that. I want you to know the old saying, it may not come when you want, but what? How many know that he's always on time? Mm-hmm. Somebody said, well, what about that one that died? God knows what he's doing. If one died in the faith, then God knows what he's doing. Amen. The Lord let me know. Evidently, he knows how to get you out of trouble. Sometimes it may take you going through the grave. Mm-hmm. I never will forget, we used to be taught by our leader, our founder, used to tell us that some of us gonna have to go through the grave. You got to go through the grave, just, you know, be patient. Evidently, the grave is not that bad. There is a teaching that the grave used to be a dark place. It was a dark place. In the Old Testament, they called the grave sometimes hell. Mm-hmm. But when Jesus went to it, it made it better. Amen. It made it better. It's not as bad as it used to be. Just wait on him. Yeah. Our soul wait for the Lord. He is our help. He is our shield. God will protect you. He will keep you. He will keep your hand in his hand. The problem comes sometimes that we don't want to hold on. I got to urge.
shall mount up with wings.
They shall mount up with wings.
As eagles.
As eagles.
They shall run.
They shall run.
And not be weary.
And not be weary.
And they shall walk.
They shall walk.
And not faint.
And not faint. In other words, if you wait on God long enough, we used to have this thing in simplicity. We used to continue to come to prayer service in our younger days. You received the Holy Ghost, yeah. But every time they had prayer service, we'd be right there. And back in those days, we had more prayer service than we had prayer service here that year by every day. But we had more. Philip Temple, back in the early 70s, we had prayer service in the morning time, then prayer service in the evening time. You didn't get it in the morning, you got it in the evening. Amen. But we took this as a waiting period, waiting on God. And it was a waiting period. Because when we came to the altar, we would tell God all about our problem, all about what's happened to us. The church don't pray like we used to. We don't wait on God. We don't tell God to do something for us like we used to. And then wait on God to do it. Before long, God have done it, have worked your problem out, send you on your way, and then before long, you got another problem. And God got another problem to work out for you. He will always be right there for you. Wait on him. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Our strength was continued to be renewed day by day. Why? Because we were a praying church. A praying church. We were a word church. We were in the word, in the Bible. And even the young men, would get together sometimes. Back in those days, I give an illustration. Bishop Perry and myself, Bishop Perry was my brother-in-law. And he would come and get me and say, come on, let's go over to Bishop Henderson. He wasn't Bishop Henderson, Elder Henderson. Let's go over there. I never would forget, we would go to Elder Henderson's house and go to my Clifton, not Hebrew, Clifton. We go over to his house. We always went in the back door. I used to wonder. Now he's a black man, but we're going in the back door. I wonder because I had been places. We go in the back door, and soon we come in, they start moving stuff, moving the furniture. Out the way. That's the way the old church was. We were getting ready to tear. Right. I ain't know what they were doing because I was the young one among the group. So they got to get moving stuff out of the way. Because they know we finna have a time for it. Folk don't do that no more. Don't do it no more. A lot of times when you go and visit somebody, there's a lot of gossip. A lot of talking. What's going on? And this and that. Back in those days, it was time for us to come together and pray. And pray. Then those were the days when the old man would be teaching us. Bishop Philip used to teach us that. Y'all stay out of them house service.
That's right.
Stay out of them house service. He was talking about with the other folks. There were some people that belonged to Reverend Hatcher. Right down the street from my mama. I went in there. I called myself to find out what was going on up in there. As I was walking up to Bishop, I hear Bishop tell me, say, you don't need to be in there. Went on up by fear of the Spirit. I have been saying that long, but God, you know, God will build a fence around you. God will protect you when you're in danger, in a dangerous area, spiritually so. I did good to come out of it. As soon as I got a break, though, I broke for the door. I don't need. I would do better in this day and time where I am now than then. I just said something to you all. Y'all young saints don't need to be going up in these lot of houses. Okay. Going up in these odd places, because a lot of things go on in places. You know, in some place that's called church. You don't even need to be up at think you can go anywhere and everything is what? Yeah, everything is all right. You don't have the power to fight these things off. But you, if you ever go into a place, you realize that you shouldn't have went, when you come out, you better come on back to the terrace.
Yeah,
because sometimes you don't know what to pray for, but the Spirit knows. God will come in and intervene for you. Yeah. Stay out of place. You ain't got no business. Out of church. Sometimes I'd be talking to young folk that tell me, yeah, I went here and went there, you know. You know, I'm saying to myself, I'm going to tell them, what you done up in that place, you know? What you done up in the end of it? Then they tell you all what went on. Then, a lot of them go into other places and they come back talking about here. Y'all notice that? They go other places and then they come back talking here. That's why it's necessary. If we're doing some things, that's what I'm talking about now, we're doing some things that we shouldn't be doing, we should better wait on God. Go before him and tell him all about it. Amen. Don't let nobody fool you. Don't let one of these grown saints. Don't be listening to what Bishop Petty said. You got power. You'll find out how much power you got. You'll find yourself praying and praying, which is good, but you can be using that prayer for something else. How many hear what I'm saying? You can be using that prayer for something else. And sometimes you end up, you don't be careful. The devil had you completely out of church. You be completely out of church. That would cause a lot of people to leave because they are going in places that they don't have any business to be. But I'm a strong saint. Find out how strong you really are. Devil get you back on his territory. He said, before I came out here, I learned all the rules. Yeah, but when you got there, the devil had changed all the rules. That's the way the devil worked. Huh? Maybe y'all didn't understand what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
But that was the old way. When we obeyed and did what was told us to do, somebody said, I can hear somebody thinking right now. That Bishop George, you're not that good. But I learned a lesson. I learned not to ever do it anymore. I learned. That's why you don't see me in and everywhere. You ain't gonna see me in and everywhere and patting folks on their back. Telling you all right. If you're wrong, if I go up in there, I'm gonna sit quiet and still and watch. And listen to the Spirit. When you close to God, God will talk to you. How many God talk to?
Amen.
Did God talk to y'all?
Amen.
Somebody never hear from God. But God will talk to you and let you know this is the wrong thing. You better know it for yourself. Then once you learn it, you better stay out of it. Don't break it. Don't break the rule no more. Sometimes God allows you to go and learn something for yourself. chapter 2 and 3 tell us? Tell us about sometime when we get a vision. That we don't have to do that. We get a vision. Sometimes the vision is not for right now. Is that right? Especially, you know, when it's talking about the coming of the Lord. Yeah. Yeah. It's talking about those type of visions.
For the
vision
is yet for an appointed time.
It's yet for an appointed time.
But at the end,
it
shall speak.
The vision gonna speak.
And not lie.
And not lie.
Though it tarry.
Wait for it.
Because it will surely come.
Mm-hmm.
It will not tarry.
It won't tarry. God will let you know what to do in that time. God show you something, it's gonna come to pass. God show you something, it's never a lie. It's always the truth. God is not going to show you something, and it's for your big brother that did. I got a big brother that did. Somebody said, God gave me a vision for him. Whatever are you talking about? Big Elmo did. How God gonna send a vision for you? You won't lie. This is not talking about that, but I think it went through. God, if God give you a vision, the vision itself will not lie. God give it to you, and you can line it up with the word of God. It will be the truth. It will always God. God give you a vision, tell you something to tell somebody, it will not lie. And I oftentimes say that God give you a vision for one and this day and time, if not for 100 years down the line, unless it's for somebody else. All those visions, God have given to the major prophets, and they have given to who? The minor prophets. They got what? Visions for the world to come. I mean, understood what I just said. Most of the time now, when God give a vision, it's for individuals, and it would affect you in your time. Somebody said, well, I have this gift, you better wait on it. So if you've been getting visions, and the vision's been lying, that's not God. Huh? That's not God, no. And in the vision God gives you, just like this one right here, so it will not. It will not lie. He said, but at the end, it shall speak and not lie. I can't help you believe the word.
Right.
I can't help you believe the word. But that's where it is. Wait on God. In every situation, wait. The Bible tells us the eyes of all wait upon thee, and thou givest them their meat in due season. We wait on God for everything. He said, I open thy hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. God does what? He's the one that satisfies every living thing. Learn how to wait on it for everything you need. Wait on it. Hallelujah. To help you. To pay your bills. Wait on you. Hallelujah. Help you if you need a good job. To get that good job. God will do that. God will work with you as a saint of God in every situation. Just learn to wait on him. Wait on him. Trust God. Well, even if you don't trust me, that's all right. If you don't trust me, but trust Tell you again, God will bring you out tomorrow. The thing is, don't get in a hurry. Don't get up, if you don't get in a hurry, and if you're praying for somebody, don't go and tell them, you're going to do what you want to do now. God, don't wait. Wait till God wake it up.
All right, bless you.
When it wakes up, then you know. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Some people want to take the place of God. You can't take the place of God. You hear me oftentimes say that God won't give his gold.
True love.
I don't care how you, try to explain it, how you lie about it. It won't come to pass. If you give God time, he will fix it. The song says he'll fix it. How many times?
Every
time. God will fix it every time. I trust God. Mm-hmm. I trust him. I have trust God. Ever since God saved me, filled me with the Holy Ghost, I know him now. I just about know how he works. Tell it to him. Hallelujah. Now, the younger days, we're trying to figure it out. Do God hear my prayer? Sometimes you feel like God don't hear your prayer. How many feel like that? You praying? A belt like that. Let's say folks don't want you to know you still feel the same way. So they ain't gonna answer. But some been with the Lord, walking with him, walking beside him a long time. And they think that God don't hear your prayer. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. I learned from a young minister, Eliezer. He and him was talking, you know. He said, he let me know. I seem like we was at Old Adams Street, right in front of Old Adams Street. He said, sometimes when you pray, you feel like God didn't hear your prayer. He said, but God hear you. When he told me that, it went in my spirit. How many know what you think going in your spirit? Mm-hmm. Went in my spirit. Here I am, you know, probably about almost 50 years later, now you're still telling the same thing. And I realized then that God does hear our prayer when we don't know that he's listening. He's listening to your every cry. When you live for him and you belong to God, God will work it out for you every time. God will not forsake you. That's why you don't have to worry about this. Going against the enemy, don't worry about the enemy. Let him go and do what he want to do. Hallelujah. Somebody said, go and eat from him. And do this, I ain't going to eat from him. The enemy. You know, he may do something to you. Make you sick. Mm-hmm. Yeah. If I know he's trying to hurt me, I'm not going to help him. The Bible said, I tempt the Lord. Thank God for the lesson tonight. Wait on it.